Very good afternoon, one and all present here. I, Surbhi Raghuvanshi.
And I, Purnima Mandana.
Here to present our topic, the rise and fall of Nirma.
So, why we choose this topic? Because of the Nirma story. That's our very exciting and motivation. Because the Nirma taught us the management lessons. That's to be proactive and taking up responsibilities. To define the segmentations and to be a focus, a building on a brand.
When we heard a name Nirma, what comes to your mind? Exactly. So we having a one more jingle here. Can you play a video, please?
So next slide. So today we will cover a lot of contents that we started from the introduction.
So it starts with the introduction. So company Nirma is a group of Nirma is a city of Ahmedabad, which manufactures many products, and it's a FMCG company which once a time is a very strong and very successful brand, and it's a strong rival of a Hindustan Unilever Limited. Now it's still having a very clear mindset and clear image brand name till now, and it's one of the brand which recognizes a true Indian brand. It's founded in 1969. It's headquartered in Ahmedabad, and its founder is Dr. Karshan Bhai Patel. Change the slide, please. So vision of Nirma: better quality product and services to maximize the customer value, and this mission is better products, better value, and better living. Change the slide.
So as the journey of the Nirma, Nirma was born when a chemist structure manufacture phosphate free detergent, and suddenly started selling its product. So at that time, the product was detergent price was 15 rupees per kg, but now Nirma was having only 3.5 rupees kg. So at the initial and starting from basic year beginning, he started the production and packaging in his backyard, and it's 10 to 12 feet room in his house. In early stage, he used a bicycle and selling out the 15 to 20 products in a day. So it's rapidly become a very popular in a rural market, and it's become a status, a beloved, a low cost and value of money. So from the two, it's becoming one of the largest and more integrated detergent company, and over 80 tons and annually 38% market share in 2000. So it's become a dream to become a reality. So the products of the Nirma was divided into two parts, that is the industrial products and consumer brands. So the industrial products which is used in the lab, so that's mostly glycerin, soda ash, sodium silicate and further. And so consumer brands having a home care and personal care. The home care edible salts and scouring products, we're having the Nirma clean detergent, Nirma clean bar, having dish bar and further. Where the detergents are there, the cake and powder. The personal care was having a bath soaps, having a Nirma Fresh, Nirma Sandal, Nirma Rose, and etc.
We come here the factors of the factor that give rise to the Nirma at 90s. So the main factor is Nirma's ad campaign. The Nirma's ad campaign includes that is created entirely a market segment in the domestic marketplace, which gives a rise a boom to the Nirma company at 90s. And its mascot of Nirma girl, which is become very famous at that time, a catchy jingle which we are seeing, seen in the video, and characters of Hema, Rekha, Jaya, and Sushma. The targeting housewife, Nirma just changed the habit of housewife in the India. It's changed its habit of washing of clothes. And the chief price at the start, the Kashan Bhai Patel sell their products at door-to-door marketing. They do door-to-door marketing and sell their product at very cheap price at only 3 rupees per kg, which becomes very effective to boom the Nirma company and to achieve that success. It's competitive. At that time, there's not so much competition for Nirma. But after globalization and liberalization, the FMCG company becomes so large. The competition so becomes so huge that many companies are emerged at that time. Now, at today's scenario, the companies like ITC products, Marico, PNG products, HUV, it's a major main competitors for Nirma in India.
So the reasons for the fall, and we saw the lots of competitors are there, but the Nirma having spent only 3-4% revenue in the market communications, and other companies will spend 6-8%. So the Nirma started its begin with the advertisement of the beauty soaps with the Sonali Bandre, and he was not popular at that time. He was not popular at that time, but there will be a classic time in the market when the brand ambassador will be a. When the brand ambassador will be a reflect the brand's image. So the reasons of the lack of innovations, the company failed to innovate its products and failed also view and also observe the environments. The second one is the diversification. The diverse were winning the products and portfolio failed to feel the plus of the market, as diversifications did not help them. The consumer perceptions, as we know all, the Nirma was a very very inferior brand, but it was a low cost. So the lack of the focus, Nirma failed to understand what they are good at. Next. The marketing strategy, the first one is the segmentations. The having low end segment and rural households. The basically all are belonging to the bottom of the pyramid. The second one is the targeting. It is spread across a huge market and excellent distribution channel. The third one is positioning. The positioning of the Nirma itself, it's being affordable products and people who are not affordable and looking for the more reasonable and value for money.
Change the slide. This is the revenue and market share of Nirma. At revenue financial year in 2018 and 2019, more than 3,550 crore rupees, and it is the Nirma having a market share of 12%. So conclusion, from the above slide we can conclude that Nirma's success lies in the detergent powder and products, and that the segment started declining when they entering into new segment or they tried to introduce products of other product lines.
So the brand revitalization is possible. The advertisement campaign can be organized in a way to introduce nostalgia into customers for its re-entry.
Thank you.